venous drainage and lymphatic drainage of lower limb. So in this we will be covering facial lata, venous drainage, lymphatic drainage, retinacula and dermatomes of lower limb. So first we will start with facial lata. Coming to attachments, it is a tough sheet that envelops the thigh like a sleeve, and its attachments proximally to the inguinal ligament, anteriorly, laterally to the iliac crest, posteriorly it is attached to sacrum, coccyx and sacrotuberous ligament, and medially it is attached to pubis, pubic arch, pubis, pubic arch and ischial tuberosity. Distally, the facial lata is attached around the knee joint to the bony prominences. Then intermuscular septa, the facial lata gives three intermuscular septa which arise on its deeper aspect, and these intermuscular septa divide the thigh into three compartments, that is the anterior, medial and posterior compartments. And these intermuscular septa are attached to linea aspera. Then there is one more thickening of the facial lata, that is called as iliotibial tract. So iliotibial tract is a thickened lateral aspect of facial lata. It extends from iliac crest, that is the anterior part of iliac crest, to the lateral side of knee joint, and this iliotibial tract splits into two layers superiorly, and the tensor facial lata muscle lies in between the two layers of the split iliotibial tract, and the function of iliotibial tract is stabilizes knee joint in extension. Then we go to venous drainage of lower limb. The venous blood of lower limb is drained against gravity. The factors that help in the drainage are the contraction of the calf muscles, particularly the soleus, then one-way valves that prevent blood reflux into superficial veins, pulsations of adjacent arteries, and negative pressure created in the thoracic cavity during inspiration. So these are the factors that help in venous drainage. Then classification of the lower limb veins. The veins of the lower limb are classified anatomically and functionally into three types. They are superficial veins, perforating veins and deep veins. So first we will start with superficial veins. The superficial veins are great and small saphenous veins. The great saphenous vein, it lies in superficial fascia. It is the longest vein of the body. It begins on the dorsum of foot by the union of medial end of dorsal venous arch and medial dorsal digital vein of big toe. Coming to course of the great saphenous vein, it runs superiorly, anterior to medial malleolus, crosses obliquely the medial surface of lower third of tibia, then it ascends behind the medial border of tibia to reach the knee joint. Here it lies posterior medial to the knee joint. It runs upwards along the medial side of thigh, It reaches saphenous opening. It pierces the cribriform fascia and the femoral sheath. And finally, it drains into femoral vein. Coming to valves. There are 20 valves, that is 10 to 20 valves in the great saphenous vein. Out of these, two are important valves. One lies just before it pierces cribriform fascia, and other lies at the saphenofemoral junction. In about 80% of individuals, the external iliac vein has a valve that protects saphenofemoral vein against high venous pressure. In the remaining 20 cases that lack this valve or at the risk of saphenofemoral valve failure and development of varicose veins. Then we go to small saphenous vein. It is the continuation of lateral end of dorsal venous arch. It runs in the middle of back of leg. It pierces the roof of popliteal fossa and drains into popliteal vein. Then we go to perforating vein. The perforating veins connect superficial veins with deep veins. They are called so because they perforate deep fascia. The perforators are classified into direct perforators. Direct perforators connect the superficial veins with the deep veins directly. Indirect perforators, they connect superficial veins with the deep vein through muscular venous plexus of soleus. Then, where are they located? Where are they located? Location of perforators. There are four fairly constant locations of perforators. Adductor canal perforator. It connects great saphenous vein with femoral vein. Knee perforator. It connects great saphenous vein with posterior tibial venae cavities. Lateral ankle perforators. It communicates small saphenous vein with peroneal venae cavities. And there are three medial ankle perforators. They connect great saphenous vein with posterior tibial venae cavities. Then what is varicose veins? They are the dilated tortuous superficial veins of lower limb filled with blood. And this commonly occurs following prolonged standing due to incompetency of the walls either in the perforating valves or that of saphenofemoral junction. Then we go to lymphatic drainage of the lower limb. This consists of two systems, deep and superficial. The superficial system consists of six different bundles. Out of those, two are distal, that is in the leg and foot. And they are great saphenous bundle and small saphenous bundle. Then there are four proximal bundles that are located in the thigh, and they are two in the anterior aspect and two in the posterior aspect. They are named as anterior medial, anterior lateral, posterior medial and posterior lateral. Then great saphenous bundle. The great saphenous bundle of leg extends upwards and continues as anterior medial bundle of thigh. Then we have anterolateral bundle, which is also called as accessory saphenous bundle. It originates in the thigh so that there is no connection between this bundle and the lymphatics of leg. Then we go to deep drainage, distal. Deep lymphatic drainage of the lower limb has 5 lymphatic bundles. They are 3 in the distal leg, 3 distal in the leg and foot, and 2 proximal in the thigh. The deep lymphatic bundles are the foot and leg are divided into anterior and 2 posterior. The anterior bundle is named as anterior tibia. Out of posterior, the posterior medial is also called as posterior tibial, and posterior lateral is also called as fibular bundle. Then deep drainage proximal. In the thigh, deep lymphatic bundles accompany the femoral artery and the deep femoral artery, that is profunda femoris, and drain into deep inguinal lymph nodes. Then coming to lymph nodes. Lymph nodes have both the deep and superficial lymph nodes. The superficial lymph nodes are found in the subcutaneous, inguinal and popliteal regions. Coming to superficial inguinal lymph nodes. There are 6 superficial inguinal lymph nodes. 3 are located inferiorly and they contain 1 single node and they are named as great saphenous, lateral accessory saphenous and intersaphenous. And there are 3 cranial to the saphenofemoral junction and they are multinodal and they are the superficial circumflex iliac, superficial epigastric and external pudendal. Superficial external pudendal. Coming to drainage, the lymphatic drainage of the lower limbs reaches inferior, that is great saphenous, lateral accessory saphenous and intersaphenous, and the superior ones receive lymph from infraumbilical abdominal area, gluteal region, external genitalia and part of uterus. Then we go to popliteal region. In the popliteal region, superficial popliteal node receives lymph from posterolateral bundle of leg. Then deep lymph nodes. They are located in the leg, that is they are located in the leg, popliteal region and also inguinal region. They are usually situated near the origin of arteries. They are anterior tibial, posterior tibial and fibular. And they receive lymph from leg and foot. Deep popliteal. Coming to deep popliteal. Deep popliteal chain usually contains 10 lymph nodes, out of which 1 is anterior to popliteal artery and the remaining 9 lymph nodes are related to popliteal vein. Then deep popliteal, this entire group drains lymph from deep facial portions of leg, foot and also receive lymph from superficial area through the perforated vessels. Then we go to deep inguinal. The deep inguinal lymph nodes are located medial to the femoral vein and deep to saphenous femoral junction. There are few lymph nodes as compared to superficial. And 1 node is always present, that is near the lacunar ligament and is called as Clockwart's lymph node. This chain receives lymph from different vessels coming or accompanying the femoral artery and also from superficial area. So concluding, after the inguinal lymph nodes, lymph will go to axillary iliac, then common iliac lymph nodes. Subsequently, it passes through lumbar aortic lymph nodes and that form lumbar trunks and finally drain into thoracic duct. Then we go to retinacula. Of the ankle. So first we will start with superior extensor retinacula. It is a transverse rectangular band located above the ankle joint. It attaches laterally to lower fibula and medial tip of anterior crest of tibia and medial malleolus. The structures passing deep to retinaculum include tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus, peroneus tertius, anterior tibial blood vessels, deep peroneal nerve, and it is approximately 6 to 9 millimeters, that is 5 millimeters to 1 centimeter above the ankle joint. Then we go to superior peroneal. It prevents dislocation of peroneal tendons. It is a transverse tendon. It extends from retromalleolar groove to the tip of lateral malleolus. And it is continuous with deep fascia of leg. Then we go to inferior extensor retinaculum. It is a Y-shaped structure located on the anterior aspect of tarsal bones and ankle joint. It is a complex structure that has four components, and the components are stem, oblique superior medial band, oblique inferior medial band, and oblique superior lateral band. Then inferior extensor stem. The stem acts like a sling, retaining the tendons of extensor digitorum longus, peroneus tertius muscles against the talus and calcaneus. Then coming to bands, superior medial band continues in the direction of the stem and it passes over the tendon of extensor hallucis longus and gets inserted on the anterior aspect of medial malleolus. Then coming to inferior peroneal, it is an oblique rectangular band. It originates from sinus tarsi. It extends downwards and posteriorly to get inserted in relation to the trochlear process on the retrotrochlear eminence. Then we go to flexor retinaculum. It is located medially, enclosing the tarsal tunnel. It is triangular in shape. It extends from the medial malleolus to the posterior superior aspect of calcaneus. The base is continuous with plantar aponeurosis. Then we go to dermatomes. T12 is related to suprapubic area. L1 is external genitalia. L2 is lateral half of thigh. L3 is medial side of thigh. L4 is medial side of leg dorsum of foot and big toe. L5 is lateral side of leg dorsum of foot and also second, third and fourth toes. Continuing with dermatomes, S1, lower lateral surface of leg lateral margin of foot and little toe. So we stand on S1 and we sit on S3. On the foot, medial to lateral, they are L5 and S1, that is both plantar and dorsum. Then coming to dermatomes, hip extension is by L4 and 5, flexion is by L2 and 3, knee extension L3 and 4, flexion L5 and S1, ankle plantar flexion S1 and 2, dorsiflexion L4 and 5, knee jerk dermatomes are L3 and 4, Achilles jerk S1 and 2, biceps jerk C5 and 6, and triceps C7 and 8. Thank you.